Sleep. Humans spend a third of our lives sleeping. It's important for every aspect of the human body. Scientists have devoted their life's work to trying to find ways to optimize sleep. Sports teams from around the world have spent millions on sleep specialists who have designed sleep-inducing wallpaper, tailored sleep schedules to each player's circadian rhythm, and many other quirky techniques to optimize sleep. And as somebody who really values a good night's sleep, I've always been searching for something which can help me either fall asleep quicker or just improve the quality of my rest. But I think I might have found something on which I'm very excited to share with you. One night, I was just scrolling on YouTube, probably procrastinating, trying to avoid doing work. And then I stumbled across this video.
I want to get into some personal things. Sleep with your head. No. Once you lay down like this, every nerve cell in your body is pulled due north. So if you're sleeping north, there's no pull. Just like it pulls a compass, it pulls every nerve cell in your body.
The man in this video is Dick Gregory. He was quite a famous comedian back in the 60s and 70s. But this got me thinking, could this really be true? Does the Earth's magnetism have any effect on our nerve cells whatsoever? And could this really affect the way we sleep? I decided to go down this rabbit hole, and this is what I found. Where to begin? Well, firstly, is the Earth really a magnet? Well, yes it is. It's a huge magnet. If you need a visual representation, then just imagine one of these, with the poles acting as the positive and negative ends. Now, if you go onto Google and you search up something like, I don't know, does the Earth's magnetic pull affect sleep, you won't get much. You just get shot down by forums where no olds can write whatever they want. So if we avoid the Quoras and Reddits and just focus on scientific proof, then you'll stumble across this 30-year-old scientific paper. Influence of the Earth's magnetic field on resting and activated EEG mapping in normal subjects. So an EEG is just something that measures the electrical activity of your brain. So we found in a former investigation that by measuring sleep parameters, the REM latency is shortened in the east to west position of sleepers compared with the north to south position. There are statistically significant differences in the EEG of normal subjects, depending on whether the subjects sit facing the north to south or east to west direction. The problem with this paper, apart from the fact that it's 30 years old, is I tried really hard to actually get the full paper. I just couldn't find the complete paper. Also, there were terms like REM and alpha power, but what exactly does that mean? So before I go any further, let me just quickly go over the sleep cycle. In a normal sleep cycle, there are four stages. Stage 1, Rip Van Winkle falls asleep. This stage lasts about 7 minutes. Stage 2, your temperature starts to drop. Your brain activity decreases and eye movement stops. Half of sleep is spent here. Stage 3, deep sleep. This is the most important part, as scientists believe this is where all restorative sleep happens. Stage 4, REM. Brain activity picks up. REM is where vivid dreams start to happen. In a night of sleep, a person will usually go through 6 of these cycles. Back to the video. Now that I went over the sleep cycle, I finally understood what shortening REM latency meant. So it seemed like what Dick Gregory said actually had a bit of substance to it. And so after a more comprehensive search, I found this paper. Since 1984, it's known that some sodium and potassium voltage comes on. And so the inevitable happened. I got totally confused. Now I can show you the footage of me reading this paper and going back on myself and going forward and then backwards to try and understand, or I could just give you a summary and link the papers down below and you can read them and you can make your own opinion. Basically, the summary from this paper is that we have sodium and potassium voltage gated channels, and these channels create action potentials when there's a difference in charge or electricity, if you will. And so what this paper said is that there is definitely a pull, there's a magnetic pull that does affect these potassium and sodium channels, and these can actually cause action potentials to start firing off. And I quote, in summary, it has been shown that the magnetic field gradient created by a permanent magnet is able to exert pressures on different homogeneous biological media which induce surface tensions whose strengths can alter substantially the gating probability of mechanosensitive channels, so the sodium and potassium gated channels. So the question that I asked myself after reading the first paper was, so what exactly is this pull? What is this magnetic pull that could potentially be affecting these action potentials or the neurons firing off, as Dick Gregory summed it up? And that's where this second paper comes into play. Now, what this paper is saying is that the magnetic field that the Earth creates causes something called torque, which is basically pressure. And this paper basically says that in the east to west direction, so in the perpendicular direction, there is a greater torque to the north to south direction. And the difference in torque or pressure between the perpendicular and parallel is 10 to the minus 20 joules per neuron, which is an incredibly small difference, but it's still a big difference considering we're talking each singular neuron. So it's true. What Dick Gregory said is true. It has been scientifically proven that there is greater torque or pressure in an east to west direction than in north to south. So what can we take away from this? What we can take away is, sure, the difference is minuscule, it's 10 to the minus 20 joules per neuron, but it's still enough to affect the process of neurons firing off. So I'm not going to sit here and say that if you start sleeping in a north direction instead of a west direction, you're going to get a much better sleep. But scientifically, there will be less pull on your neurons if you do sleep in a parallel direction instead of a perpendicular direction. Now, whether this affects your sleep will remain to be seen, but I can say from personal experience, the last 10 days or so, I've been sleeping knowingly in a north direction with my head pointing north. Now I've been sleeping far better and far more comfortably when I've been in the north to south than in the east to west.
Leave a comment down below and tell me if this has worked for you. Catch you guys in the next one.